Nada. se fac mai multe codițe până la sfârșit, cea doar una din.
Tot ce a însemnat al doilea război mondial și toate precușurile și luptele care au fost în zonă, ca apoi să vină Partidul Comunist și să-i spună, hei, uite, ai 7 copii, nu sunt puțini deloc, dar hai să-ți luăm din casă, în caz că nu avem nevoie de spațiul ăla, nu ne pasă de tine, ceau. Și el a preferat să dărâme jumatea aia de casă decât să lase pe altcineva să distrugă amintirile și copilăria copiilor. Și cam asta ar fi. Poveștile, ceea ce mi se pare mie important, e că indiferent că rămâneți cu povești clare sau cu personaje clare în minte, e important impactul emoțional pe care ideile astea le au asupra voastră. Personajele astea sunt mai degrabă niște idei. Fiecare spune câte ceva. Am supraviețuit într-o perioadă grea. Am trecut peste un eveniment greu care m-a traumatizat, dar uite, am reușit să găsesc bucuria în viață după aia și nu am fost doar o carcasă goală care a continuat să supraviețuiască, ci am și reușit să mă bucur de viață în continuare.
dulceață, pălinca finată, lichiorte, nucă, vindecoacăze.
did your Michigan State to just continue to fight and battle. Colin Spitz behind Blake Buter. That.
This grass, native Colorado grass, spotted.
I saw a lot of deer.
Even yeah, we saw a deer.
Yeah, you saw one?
Yeah.
I like that one because you're on top, and so it's kind of flowy. It's not so much.
Yeah. It's not much elevation.
A lot of these that are trails we do, you have to.
So maybe you're higher. I don't know. I'm curious if you are low aerobic.
Well, when I was. I have another account I use in red.
Oh yeah. Well, put
also.
It in your
also.
Yeah. See you.
Close the garage door.
How?
The white button right there.
That white button?
Yeah.
Okay. Have fun.
A lot of good birds over here. There's bird watching. These people are here.
Dude, did you hear about the The Rittenhouse one?
Yes.
I heard about it, but I don't really know enough about it.
Okay, so this guy, Kyle Rittenhouse, he's visiting, comes to Wisconsin, and there's a lot of, like, this was about a year ago when the Black Lives Matter protests were happening and stuff, and so he comes to Wisconsin. I don't think he even lives in Wisconsin. I think he lives in some other fucking random state, Illinois.
Yeah.
And he comes to Wisconsin with an AR. And he's 17 at the time, so he's not even allowed to have it because he's underage.
Yeah.
That's a Class A misdemeanor. He comes in the AR, which is like one of those big guns. Automatic rifle. And during these protests, he's just out here, like, he kind of, I guess, like, sides with the cops or whatever because the cops in that area were really racist. And they were, like, out here shooting black people. And this kid just is out here shooting black people. Kills three of them, and there's a lot of video. I mean, there's not a lot of video evidence, but there's some videos where he can claim self-defense because there are people coming at him with like skateboards and stuff. But he shot three people and killed them. And the jury or the judge ruled him not guilty on all accounts.
I heard that.
He wasn't charged with one charge. There was not one charge. Not even for being in possession of the gun. He should have at least been charged with possession, right? But he claimed it was self-defense because people are coming at him with skateboards. He's literally my age. He was my age when he did it. Like, he's 18 now, but, like, he was 17 when he did it. I'm 17. I turned 18 in a month. Like, imagine me just going around shooting people. Like, how could he even, like, be in possession of a weapon like that? Sold him a gun like that.
Maybe he stole it from like someone's house.
Maybe.
Because that's how it usually goes.
I'm not exactly sure.
I mean, not usually, but that's how it can go.
That's how it can, for sure. It just really made me sick. Like, really. It just made me feel really bad.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have stuff like that going on in the Netherlands.
I'm going to pick something, if you would like to join us.
Hi.
Sometimes I'll be hitting it like up here, and it still like goes where I want it. It's pretty sweet.
Oh no!
Sometimes you can...
that? You know the Thule big ass Thule liter.
Yeah, it's a Thule liter.
Zach, switch. You got this one.
Bruh.
You suck, dude.
I've seen it. I've seen the horse.
But explain.
больше. Как ни странно, больше. Менее опасно.
I don't know. Something's drawing them to each other the whole time, you know? It's a really, it's a beautiful sentiment, I think.
Self, masculinity. It is a wonderful synth-backed anthem that is incredibly powerful, great vocals, great production. This feeling of yearning to be a part of something greater, just as previous generations were allowed to, that the millennial generation has just had robbed from them.
I love you. Yeah, that last thing I think.